Welcome to a very special 3-hour hoedown.
Tourists are the one in shorts with sandals on their feet. When I drive around, I run them over in the street. I do that for my town's own protection. I am singing this song for the ignored section.
Tourists from Japan are really the best. They're used to traveling without any rest. I look just like them, oh, what the heck? Except that I don't have a great big camera on my neck.
The other day I was at a movie. The kids were all loud. They were making noise and throwing stuff. What an ugly crowd. I told them there's something, and then they all cried. I ruined the movie, told them Bambi's mother died.
I hate it at the movies when all the kids scream. I have to admit that is really not my scene. But one thing's for sure, an usher I will not call. I just sit in front of them, I'm over 6 feet tall. So mad because that damn pizza was late. By the time it got there, it was frozen and I tried. I was so darn angry that I shot the pizza guy.
I wanted a pizza, I was really hungry. I can't cook much, so I ordered, you see. When the pizza came, it was very cold. The cheese was hard and old, and the sausage was petrified. I was really mad.
I'm waiting for my pizza. It's been 3 hours now. I'm getting really angry, just like a British cow. It really is upsetting. I'm going to really go. When he gives me my pizza, I won't give him his dough.
My uncle died yesterday, he owned a pizza place. Lying in the coffin, he looked peaceful with his face. Cooking pizzas was so fun, and his name was Sid. When I opened up the coffin, he was stuck to the lid.
I'm in advertising. No, my name is Rick, and I am really groovy, because I am not a brick. I sit and sell you stuff, stuff that you don't need, because I have one motivation, and that's massive greed.
Why don't you buy that stuff, you baby boomer? I know you've got lots of cash, you are a big consumer. Man, oh man, everything from cars to fast foods I sell. My biggest slogan, yo quiero Taco Bell.
I hate commercials. What a waste of time. Mm-hmm. They take up all the program. It really is a crime. They seem to waste all the time in my precious life. Thank God there are 60 seconds, then I can make love to my wife.
I buy lots of products when I'm at home alone. It's really, really easy. You order them by phone. Not to order these things is really kinda hard, but I never worry too much. I use Colin's credit card.
So there I am, I got a message in a bottle. I'd won a free date with a tall supermodel. She was about 6'5", but the date was really lame. I didn't have a good time cause we played the crying game.
I used to hate blind dates, they never did work out. They'd give me a kiss on the cheek and then they'd throw me out. Nowadays my blind dates go off without a hitch. I know I'm not good looking, but I'm really, really rich.
I had a blind date. It really was the pits. Nothing worked all night. I kept getting hit. She really was abusive. Man, oh man, oh man. But what else can you expect when your blind date is Roseanne?
I had a blind date just the other night. The type of girl that really shouldn't be in the light. She wasn't really attractive, she was kind of bland. But she still beat the hell out of using my right. I am losing my hair and it really is a pain. I find out every morning when I see the shower drain. But as you can see, it isn't quite for me. But at least I'm not quite as bald as Colin Mockery.
Oh man, took my rhyme. I was gonna do that.
I have all my hair and I really am quite happy. I like putting stuff in my hair, it makes me look real snappy. I love to comb my hair, I never need a breather. I'm real happy, I'm not Colin Mockery either.
People always kid me cause I'm losing all my hair. I can't really help it that I'm follically impaired. It really is quite horrible, but my life is not through. I still get way more sex than either Brad or Drew.
Losing all your hair isn't really that bad of a deal. A lot of women love just the way it feels. Just think of it as just a little more face. And you can rent it out as advertising space.
As advertising space.
Thank goodness for my mom that I was made. It was 27 years ago that my dad got. That's right, you see, upon closer inspection, I'm standing here cause he didn't use protection.
When a woman gives birth, her man is filled with pride. All through the delivery, he stands right by her side. But 9 times out of 10, she'll say to him, "You jerk, you got to do the fun part, and now I do all the work."
Is my wife. The other day she gave birth. It was the most beautiful thing on this God's earth. When I saw her do it, I said, "Oh my God, dear Ellen, looking from this angle looks like a straw passing a melon."
I came out of my mother at exactly 10 to 5. Everyone screamed and ran and yelled, "It's alive!" I can't really blame them, I guess it was kinda scary. Everyone tells me I resemble Drew Carey.
When I went to med school, I was very proud. When I got my diploma, I yelled right out loud. I did an operation, and I did my part. His name was Newt Gingrich, and I removed his heart.
I had an operation to take out my appendix. The name of my doctor was Dr. Bendix. I hope soon that I get out all my stitches, 'cause let me tell you, brother, they hurt like sons of guns.
Throughout my life I used to laugh like this, hee hee hee. Not so since I've had some major surgery. It really went horrible, it realized all my fears. Because of that surgery, I now pee out my ears.
My brother needed surgery, but we both were broke. I took him to a veterinarian as a little joke. He never complained, I didn't hear a peep. So I thought, what the hell, and had him put to sleep.
When I was growing up, my life was really fun. I was a latchkey kid, I was raised by reruns. All life was deep in me, a gap needed this to fill it. The thing I loved to say was, what you talking about, Willis?
Here's my story, hope you don't think I'm a moron. But I like to watch TV without any clothes on. Sometimes it raises a fuss, raises up a storm. 'Cause I'm always watching it in the lounge in my dorm.
The other day I went out and got a new TV. Just the thought of watching it filled me up with glee. But when I turned it on, you know, boy, I really lost it. Because the only thing it picked up was Veronica's closet.
As an actor, there's nothing on TV. I think they should have a show about me. I don't think that's odd, I don't think that's real scary. And it'll happen when I murder Drew Carey.
Got to pay your taxes to the government, because you know each dollar is so very well spent. You have got to pay them, but here's a little switch. I never pay my taxes because I am so rich.
You know I hate the IRS, they think that they're so tough. They said when I paid my taxes I didn't pay enough. To check me out they audited my mother and my sis. So I showed up naked at their door and said, hey, audit this.
I live in Canada, there is no IRS. I still have to pay taxes, but I'm not that distressed. I owe 18,000, but please understand, I'm not that worried, 'cause that's $5 American.
Singing about the IRS, a bell doesn't ring. You know I'm not very good when I have to sing. Singing these hoedowns on whose line you know. But I don't really care, 'cause I'm on another show.
Tried to buy a car. He tried to sell a lemon, but he didn't get too far. I found a lot of steals and I found a lot of deals. And then I bought a Pinto, but it didn't have no wheels.
Well, I wanted a Chevy, but I didn't want to get bored. And then I thought maybe
a Mercury, maybe I'll get me a Ford. But when it came down to it, I didn't make a fuss. But I didn't have any money anyway, so I'll just take the bus.
I met a car salesman, he didn't have no ethics. And I believed his every lie, it really was pathetic. He did horrible things that no good man ever should. I came home early, found him checking under my wife's hood.
Oh boy, those German cars, do they cost big bucks? I looked at the price tag and I am full of yucks. Oh, those Porsches more expensive than the others. Unless you're Drew Carey and get it free from Warner Brothers. Brothers!
I love the Village People, now please don't get me wrong. I love YMCA, hey girl, that's my song. But you see, in San Francisco's where they belong. And all them Village People inspired me to wear my thong.
I love the Village People, they give me confidence. Even though I'm not too bright, I am rather dense. I have a fat white body and I don't have a tan, but when I put on leather pants, I am a macho man. About the Village People, I have a lot of facts. Did you know they made a movie? Yes, they axe. It really is quite wonderful. I can't believe my eyes. If you laid them end to end, I wouldn't be surprised.
I don't like the Village People, think they're kind of rude. Don't you know their lyrics can be kind of crude? When it's on my stereo, I always hit the mute. But I'll have to admit, the Indian's kind of cute.
I've got a message to all of you gals. I'm a sensitive man, so why can't we be pals? I know sometimes in the past I haven't treated you right. That's why I'm taking hormones. Boom, I'm a transvestite.
Men can be quite mean, men can be quite bad. I bet you had a boyfriend, I bet he was a cad. I don't really like men myself, that I can tell. But my friend Ryan, well, he thinks they're swell.
I am a man. I love films with violence. I like to watch them every day, even when they don't make sense. I saw this one with a guy with a gun, his shots would never miss ya. Then he'd hit you with a flower, he was dirty Hare Krishna.
Let me tell you all about men, I walk the walk. I don't care what people say, just let them talk. All the rumors going around, yeah, they're kind of scary. I guess I'm gonna have to stop a showering with Drew Carey.
Here we go. You can shut me up, I promise I won't ramble. I always go to Vegas if I wanna ramble. But this time my reason is a beaut. I'm gonna go to Vegas to get a prostitute.
Oh, if you ever gamble, take some advice from Drew. There's something you should never, ever, ever, ever do. What's the best advice? The best advice, I guess, is if you ever win big, don't tell the IRS.
Thank you.
After playing strip poker, I'm naked at the table. Gee, I feel really bad, I'm really quite unstable. There's nothing worse than sitting there in your birthday suit. Never play strip poker at a correctional institute.
I just heard that Vegas just went broke. Apparently it's because of just one single bloke. I never thought that they'd ever see this day, but that's what happens when Drew Carey eats buffet. Drew Carey eats buffet.
I look forward to Christmas each and every day, but this year I got no presents and I don't know what to say. I guess that old Santa Claus was nothing but a liar, and there was a funny smell when I lit the fire.
Christmas is a holiday that I really hate. There's nothing about it to which I can relate. So every December 25th, I kick off my shoes and go down to the deli and hang out with the Jews.
Up in the North Pole, the elves all went on strike. Santa didn't care, he said, go on, take a hike. Things were horrible that Christmas, it all just turned to poo. As Shakespeare said, remember, to thine own elf be true.
I love when Santa goes, delivers all the toys. I love to see the smiles on all the girls and boys. Really is a holiday, a time to pause. Every Christmas Eve you'll find me
Woo! Boy, oh, listen, nothing amuses me than sitting at home and watching reality TV. Now that show comes, I think that it's the bomb, until I turn it on and say, damn, that's my mom.
Yeah. I love me a cop show, of that you can be sure. Until one night I'm watching and they bust down my door. They bring inside a deputy, they bring inside a jailer, and then they confiscated everything inside my trailer.
I saw a cop show, it really made me mad. It was so horrible, the writing, it was sad. More I watched it, the more it was the pits. It had Abe Vigoda and Eric Estrada, it was called Fish and Chips.
Yeah. Oh boy, those cop shows, they give me such a fright. And it seems like they are on every single night. Sure, you can watch him if you really want to scare. Thursdays at 8, you can see Melissa's underwear. I hate it when they cut it, boy, they're such a snob. But I guess in a way, that is just their job. They sit backstage and they act all snooty, but I hope they don't cut Melissa's nice tight booty. Talking about traffic, it is boring all the time. It's hard to think about something that'll rhyme. Traffic, oh, who cares? It's got no kind of class. Once again, I gotta mention Melissa's ass.
Just the other day, my husband said to me, darling, why don't we start a family? What a silly notion, what a silly whim. Why do I need children when I've already got him?
I don't pay alimony, I don't pay child support. I don't pay nothing of no kind of that sort. I get to keep all the money that I'm paid. How can you have any children if you never ever get hey!
My wife always bugged me to start a family, but I had a real low sperm count, so it was hard, you see. So we did something that I think was really bold. We adopted triplets. They're girls and 18 years old.
The wife and I just had a kid again. I guess this brings the grand total, I think it is 10. How we had another, I just can't see. Since 2 years ago, I had a vasectomy. Vasectomy.
Every family reunion is such an awful night. It's my whole family getting in a fight. Then later on, they try and do a dance, but it's not a family reunion till my uncle drops his pants.
Don't like talking about my family. No siree, Bob, that's not the subject for me. But let me ask you a question. Tell me, Jack, am I adopted? 'Cause the rest of my family's black.
Hey, family reunion, about which I'm about to sing. Strange things are always happening. I went to see my favorite uncle, but he was not there. He had an operation, now he is my Aunt Claire.
I wanna see my relatives, but don't you know it's not right? Every time we get together, all we do is fight. I wanna see my family, but don't you know I can't? We are from the South, and my sister is my aunt.
My sister is my aunt!
Now here's a little something that I have to say. There's one person who ruins a matinee. Always trying to stop me, yes I bet. That movie Usher wants to touch my raisinets.
The other day to the movies, man, I had a go. The music wasn't much and the plot, it was so-so. Don't you think that one day I'd be learning? Never go to the movies and do an impression of Pee Wee Herman.
I put down all my money. I got in a fight with the usher. It wasn't funny. I hit him really hard. He wished he never wasn't born. And to get his revenge, he peed in my popcorn.
I'm at the movie theater every Tuesday without fail. This time I'm going to see a swashbuckling tale. I am gonna sit in the back row, watch it from afar. And this pirate movie, it is rated R.
Took a field trip to the zoo. I was really mischievous, so here's what I would do. But my crime, damn it, made me dance. I tried to put a cheetah and a rhino in my pants.
When I go out to a store, I never like to pay. I got 5-finger discount, I just take it away. I never pay for nothing, I don't pay no rent. And I never tell the truth, cause I'm the president. Something, it really was a sin. It was a little revolver made of gelatin. It really was a bad idea, something I should have slept on, cause I was arrested for carrying a congealed weapon.
Shopping the correct way can be such a bore. I have to steal everything when I go in a store. Not to loot and take things can be really hard, but I guess I shouldn't, cause I am a security guard. I had to wait for cable installation the whole day. It really made me mad that for TV I must pay. So when he came to the door, what did he see? I was wearing a negligee and I got cable for free.
Oh, you might think it's risky for a guy like me to be making fun of the cable company. Won't that cost you lots of money? No, because I'm not on cable. I'm on ABC.
With my new cable, I have a lot of choice. Some of it makes me happy, some of it makes me moist. Gee, it's a lot of fun. I'm happy as a mouse. Now all day I can see Full House.
I really hate my cable guy, he makes me wait all day. There is one guy that I really don't want to pay. Then one sunny day I really got my wish. I murdered my cable guy and then I got a dish.
Around the school feeling full on totally geeky, but the thing I hated most when I went to the dance was getting dragged across the lawn in my underpants.
Well, I hated high school. I did not have a ball. I just hated walking through the hall. I hated going to every class, because the pimples on my face, but now they're on my ass.
The hardest time of my life was going through puberty. It seemed like everything around just excited me. Now listen to me now, this isn't one of my rants. When you go through puberty, do not wear sweatpants.
I didn't handle the puberty thing too well. In fact, for me, it was like going to hell. And it was kind of embarrassing, if the truth be told, cause when I went through it, I was 42 years old.
42 years old.
Every time it's Halloween, woo, make room. Because I have the world's best costume. Yep, you see me get a sheet, man. Because I'll pull it over my head and go as a Ku Klux Klan.
Halloween's the only time I get a girl. That's the only time I really give it a whirl. Never get anyone pregnant. How is that, you ask? Well, it's real easy. I wear a rubber mask.
Thank you.
it would be fair if I gave all the kids one real big scare. It went way too far and now I'm being sued. This is the last year that I go as a nude.
I have to say that Halloween is my favorite day. When I open up the door, kids and mothers run away. I have no costume, I don't care in the land. I open up the door, I've got my penis in my hand. What do you want? Let me tell you something happened just the other day. My date was so ugly, I almost ran away. She was just horrific, where can I begin? When that heifer was born, her mama should have pushed her back in.
I met a girl in a nightclub, it was pretty dark. Thought I'd take her home, just for a lark. But when I saw her in the light, I ran a mile. 'Cause she looked just like Ryan Stiles.
I'm an ugly woman. Yes, it is not fair. I have ugly face and I have no hair. What can I do? That's the way the fates went. The only person who'll sleep with me is the president.
So ugly that I'll never have a lover. When I leave the house, all the dogs run for cover. I'm big and white and round, and my back is real hairy. Yes, you guessed it, my name is Drew Carey.
I went up to Drew's house because he's getting married. He's gonna be married to the girl that'll be Mrs. Drew Carey. He said there'd be a stripper and there wasn't. It was scary, 'cause when the stripper came out, it was Drew Carey. At a bachelor party, we took off our clothes. It was pretty wild, heaven knows. I was embarrassed when I went to tip her. Turned out my mother was the stripper.
I went to a bachelor's party. I really had a ball. Boy, I consumed an awful lot of alcohol. In fact, it was really bad. In fact, it spelled my doom. 'Cause when I awoke, I found I'd married the groom.
My friends threw me a party, I knew that I was sunk. We stripped right down all night long, got really drunk. Dancing with my naked friends, boy, that's the life. As a matter of fact, to hell with my wife.
Such a louse. He's just like Jar Jar Binks, 'cause he is always rude, peeking in my window when I'm break dancing nude.
I once had a neighbor, living there was really hard. I used to find legs and arms buried in my yard. My husband said, honey, you really should be calmer. But I said, it's your fault, but we moved next to Jeffrey Dahmer.
With drunks and naked girls are happening next door. There is an awful racket, it's shaking up my floor. There's in and out and things are happening. I know I shouldn't grouse, but boy, I hate living next.
next to the White House.
I really hate the guy who lives next door to me. I wish he would move real far so I couldn't see. People running naked, it's really, really scary. But I guess that's what you get when you live next door to Drew Carey.
Oh, I got married about a year ago. I'm as happy as can be, I think you all should know. But my wife, I'm glad I did marry. Except in the morning, she looks like Drew Carey.
Well, Wayne gets worried about his little wife, 'cause she is the love of his life. But every night, just about three, oh, Wayne, she's out with me.
Out of me with her ugly hair and scars all you can see. Marrying someone that ugly really wasn't my plan. I accidentally married Dennis Rodman.
You know that my wife, she is my best pal. I will have to say that she is quite a gal. When it comes to wives, she is the best. She's the finest in the land. Now I'll get some sex.
Here's a little fact that I think you ought to know. I got out of jail about 2 months ago. I'm stuck in my house all alone because of this bracelet. I can never leave my home. Ow!
Idea fun is to go to Alabama to see all my friends who are stuck there in the slammer. Then I find a frog or a tadpole and I take them into a room and I violate parole.
I've got a probation officer. He's not very tough. He doesn't have that many rules. My life is not that rough. Life is pretty easy if you know what I mean, 'cause my probation officer is Charlie Sheen.
My officer wants me to go back to jail. I thought I was scot-free, I thought that I'd made bail. When I go back, I know that I will do life. The really bad part is that I'm everybody's wife.
I'm everybody's wife.
I watch game shows, I watch them all day long. I watch all of them and they have real great theme songs. But there is something I'd understand with my wife if they had a game show in South Central, it'd be called Run For Your Life.
What did I say?
I hate to tell the story 'cause myself it might embarrass, but the other night I went out with the daughter of Chuck Barris. When we went to make love, she did something that's wrong. I took off my pants and she gave me the gong.
I'm a game show host, my life's a game, you see. I fill it all with danger, I'm in jeopardy. It really is quite wonderful, I do it with all my might. I hang out with prostitutes because the price is right.
I'm on a game show competing against a girl. When I look at her, it sends my heart in a whirl. To beat her at this game, it would be so heinous. I answer to this question, it must be.
Mm.
place. Michael Jackson had surgery to fix his face. He didn't think that he looked good. He started sulking. I saw him the other day. He looks just like Macaulay Culkin.
All right, okay. I know something nice. It isn't so darn nasty. You could just be a doctor and go giving rhinoplasty. Michael Jackson had some. It wasn't just his loss. Instead of one Michael Jackson, now there's two Diana Ross.
Plastic surgery didn't work, I must confess. My face is now one big bad mess. Here's a little hint, if any of you go, make sure your doctor isn't Dr. Picasso.
I wanted surgery, but my doc said no. I had to force him because I had no place to go. I had to threaten him with my big old Mauser. Now I look just like a grown-up Doogie Howser. A grown-up Doogie Howser. Tell you something, just listen to my song. I was on the beach, I got something caught in my thong. The pain was immense, I thought that I would hurl. A little piece of sand got trapped, I made a pearl.
Oh, I went on vacation and it was grand. I got lots of sleep and I got really tan. Now I'm back to work, don't want to sound like a leech, but man, do these hoedowns really is a beach.
I vacationed at the beach, I really had to frown. I was splashing in the water and I started to drown. Water went into my lungs, I spluttered and I coughed. Next thing I woke up having mouth to mouth with David Hasselhoff.
I went to the beach and boy was the water cold. I got in anyway because I was bold. When I jumped in it was colder than I feared. That's the day that my penis disappeared.
Here's what I do, you see. I'd make it my mission to help celebrities. I'd even help one guy who I consider my friend. I spend all of my money to make Michael Jackson black again.
Well, if I won the lottery, here's what I would do. I'd buy a car and maybe a house or two. But this is what I'm wondering, and this is what I'm asking. If you won the lottery, why would you waste it on Michael Jackson?
I'm sitting here on my couch watching the TV. They're picking all the numbers of my favorite lottery. I am so excited when fortune calls. I've never been so happy with someone picking my...
Winning the lottery would be kind of funny. Boy, I don't know what I'd do with all that money. A lot of people think that it would be kind of scary, but I would buy the show and fire Drew Carey.
Vacation, I took a trip to the beach because it was the only stretch of land that was within reach. Oh man, it was great. You understand? When I went, I was as light as him. Now I'm a dark man.
Well, I went to the beach last week. I really caused a panic. people jumping from their blankets, falling off their hammock. Man, they were yelling, they were screaming at me. I guess I shouldn't have worn my tiny thong bikini.
I went to the beach because I'm really pale. I went skinny dipping with my pet, a great white whale. I was out in the sun too long, I got really sick. Boy, it was so horrible, I burnt my Moby.
I went to the beach with Drew, and boy, was it fun. He took off his shirt and everybody else was done. We got a place there, apartment that we leased. He was being pushed in the water by some guys from Greenpeace.
So ugly, I really did look nasty until I saw the doctor and I got rhinoplasty. I went back and I went back, I didn't know when to stop. You might not recognize me, I was the king of pop.
Well, one thing I always thought wasn't really for me was the thought of plastic surgery. But let me tell you, brother, let me tell you, Jim, before I had my face done, I used to look like him.
My plastic surgeon gave me a face that is so new, and he also threw in a hair transplant too. Oh, it's really wonderful, the people made a crack because they got all the hair from Drew Carey's back.
I went to the doctor, I thought it was funny. What I wanted to do cost a lot of money. He did it right away and never made a fuss. I took some of the inches from my feet and put them on my penis. And
if I won the lottery, I would do lots of good. I would do exactly what a friend should. Because you see, I love you guys, let me explain. I take all my money and buy Colin some Rogaine.
Oh, I won the lottery, a million smackaroos. That'll really keep me in underoos. The only thing that really is a bummer, I can't spend the money because I'm in jail for running numbers.
I have won the lottery, my riches I can flaunt. I don't care about anything, I can do anything I want.
All that money would be really hard to spend. I'm sure it seems like it would never, never end. I could give it to charities or so I am told, but I think I'll just have my penis dipped in gold.
Let me tell you something, my girlfriend, I was a slob. But now look who's laughing, astronaut, it is my job. Flying around the universe, that is my duty. I even made a pit stop in Mars and got some Martian booty. Well, I work for NASA and it is a great place. They let me take my girlfriend up into outer space. And now we're all alone up there and she sure knows how to please. And her boobs really look nice in zero G's.
I am
I'm an astronaut, but I'd rather be fishing, because I've been up in space on a 10-year mission. It really is so horrible, I'm really annoyed. I've been sitting down so long, I've got asteroids.
I think you will find my best astronaut that will be found. I can't wait to blast off and leave this ground. Soon as I get up there, oh boy, I yell, shoot. I forgot about my training and I tinkled in my suit. I tinkled in my suit.
When I start dating, they say, you're insane. Wayne, why do you take your dates up in a plane? Because I know that a girl loves the way I go. And so if the date goes well, guess who'll be yelling, Geronimo!
Well, I say skydiving's the best way to call it off. When you and your girlfriend had just had enough. And here's how you do it, don't think that I'm insane. You get her up there, take her shoot off, and kick her off the plane.
I jumped out of the plane, my parachute had failed. All the blood rushed from me, my complexion paled. Everywhere you could hear my scared call. Luckily, all my urine broke my fall.
I was skydiving when my parachute failed. I couldn't stop, I just sailed and sailed and sailed. But I looked around and I was no dummy. I survived 'cause I landed on Drew Carey's tummy.
I've got a job, now don't you all laugh. I work for you, Hefner, I take photographs. But I stopped the day, I don't want to be rude. But you said, hey Wayne, take pictures of Drew nude.
When I was young, I took up photography. Then I worked for Playboy. What's the best thing about working over there? Well, I saw Wayne's mom in her underwear.
How'd you know?
Gotta find mama.
I'm a photographer, but I'm not the best. I have a hard time photographing chests. I called an expert who lived out west, because when it comes to this, father knows breast.
I'm taking pictures of Drew out by his pool. He wants to be in the nude, I think that's kind of cool. He's paying me lots of money, all of it in tens. After looking at him, I think I'll need a telephoto lens.
If you don't like music, well, you better stop. I love rock musicians and those kids who sing pop. Oh, you say I don't like that music, yeah, that's what you think. But trust me, nobody gets more booty than that group in sync.
When I became a rock star, I thought it'd be sex, drugs, and rock and roll. I thought that all the women would really take their toll. But now there's this fact that really makes me loopy. Colin Mockery is my only groupie.
I am a member of the world's oldest band. I slept with every supermodel in the land. Well, I didn't get one, but that is her loss. A Rolling Stone never gets no Kate Moss.
I wanna be a rock star, oh that I can see. I think that that would be the job for me. Rock and roll isn't the best music I found, but at least they don't have to do a stinking hoedown.
I really was so ugly, I looked just like a sturgeon. And so I went to Hollywood and got myself a surgeon. He pulled it all much tighter, and here's the final crack. I got so much surgery, my ears meet in the back.
Well, I went to my plastic surgeon and said that I would let her have a crack at me to see if I could look better. Then when it was over, I said, hey, thanks for trying. At least when you got done with me, I didn't look like Ryan. My mother had plastic surgery. She uses it like a crutch. She's had it 7 times already. I think that's too much. I think that is way too much. Hey, what the heck? She's been lifted so much, her bum is at her neck.
I think I love looking better all around the clock. So I got some money and I went to see the doc. I looked in the mirror and I didn't know what to do. So I thought that I might shoot myself because I look like Drew.
Cause I am such a swinger. I could have gone on Sally, but instead I went on Springer. I never knew just what I could say. I know sometimes I can't. I came on with my transvestite gay lesbian second aunt.
Well, I died recently and I went straight to hell. What happened to me? I just can't tell. All I know is every day on TV I was a guest of Regis and Kathy Lee.
I play at the stadium of baseball games. I once got censored. That's my claim to fame. It really was done by the censor named Morgan when I told the crowd I love to play with my organ.
When I watch TV, I like to sit in the back. My favorite show is when animals attack. Once I saw this thing with a big bum, it was all hairy. Then it turned around, I noticed it was Drew Carey.
The 100th show, Hoedown.
A 100 episodes of Who's Line. Lord, it changed my life. It gave me financial security for myself and my wife. So thank you, ABC and Warner Brothers. You're my friend. Because if it wasn't for Who's Line, I'd be on UPN.
Well, today, it was our 100th show. It's been really fun. Great, don't you know? Let me just tell you something, even though it's been a blast, all you folks been watching Friends, you can kiss my ass.
A 100 episodes of Who's Line, where our name's been called. 100 shows of them saying that I'm bald. Does it hurt the friendship? Can it stand the test? Yes, it can, cause I'm hung the best.
Colin says he's hung the best, that I just can't see. I've known him for a long time, and it cannot be. He says he's got a big penis, but that's not a lock. Cause I have to tell you right now, mine's tucked in my sock.
Saturday I'm at home doing my thing, watching great big fellas run around in the ring. I sit there, me and Drew
turn off the sound, and then we get freaky and do our own version of SmackDown.
Well, I'm a wrestler, I love it, don't you see? It's really healthy and I make lots of money. The only thing I don't like that gives me such a fright is when I see Ryan in his little tights.
I am a wrestler, let me on the loose. Over the years I've taken lots of abuse. My head has been smacked, I've been hitting the turnbuckle. Because of all my injuries, I've lost the ability to rhyme.
I hate wrestling, I think they're all on the take. The way they throw themselves around, I'm sure that it is fake. The way they act, you think that they really did. But can they break a neon light by slamming it with their head?
Kiss, you get a kiss on the mouth. I've been kissed lots of times. I'm from Florida, that's the South. My first kiss, brother, it was the bomb. It wasn't from a girl in high school, it was from my mom.
Well, my first job was in fast food, don't you know? The hours real long and the pay was real low. My boss told me that he didn't like my sass, so my first kiss was a hearty kiss my ass.
My first kiss is something I won't forget. It was really luscious, boy, it was wet. It really changed my life, I'll never be the same. Oh, I wish I could remember the guy's name.
My first kiss happened when I was really drunk, but she wouldn't kiss me because she said my breast stunk. When it came to that date, I was really in a rut. I should have run some string through my mouth and out my butt.
See something, my dating life is bad. I opened up the newspaper and then I read an ad. The ad said it was great, and so I did not blunder. I opened up the door and there was Stevie Wonder.
Once I got a blind date, I really liked to smile. He was very tall though, his name was Ryan Stiles. I went right up through it, that date was pretty rough. Sure it was a blind date, but I wasn't blind enough.
I went on a blind date, her name was Lovely Kate. Everything was wonderful, boy, it really was great. And what happened next, I tell you it is true. When I went and kissed her, she went doo-doo-doo-doo-doo.
I met a girl one day who said she really liked me. Why she did, I really couldn't see. She was really turned on, she gave me types of clues. What really got her hot was all my fancy shoes.
Going to family reunions puts me in a funk. I hang out with my relatives and they all get drunk. You see, my mom in her childhood was bad. I go to these family reunions and try to find my dad.
Talk about relatives, it really makes me queasy. I don't like to talk about my family, it makes me a little uneasy. I have just one question, can you help me please? Am I adopted because my family's all Chinese?
Family reunions are things that people hate. I personally think, boy, they're really great.
I have a real good time. I know it sounds real sick, but I always go there and I can pick up chicks.
I'll never see my family, and that is just a hunch. As it turned out, we weren't a very nice bunch. Oh no, we're bad, we weren't any Hanson. I'll never see my family, cause my name is Charlie Manson. My name is Charlie Manson.
The Drunk Mother Hoedown.
Well, I knew Colin's mother, yes, I must tell the truth. When she was nursing Colin, her milk was 90 proof. She liked to kick the habit, she didn't know what to do. But if your baby looked like that, then you'd be drinking too.
Let me tell you something that happened just to me. My mama started drinking when I was just 3. Now I shouldn't let this secret slip, but my mama started drinking when she married Chip.
My mother drinks a lot, I know that isn't strange, but her behavior gets really strange. She acts as though she's from somewhere else, maybe like Venus. Oh, by the way, Chip has a little penis.
Down, it's taken mighty long. I am so sick of this bloody song. Wayne sits there and he gets to rest. His penis is large, that's why he's behind the desk.
They've got doctors, young and old, to help you with your heart or glands, or maybe when you got a cold. But my friend Colin, he dances really loose. The only doctor with his arm he needs to see is Dr. Seuss.
I love my doctor, he's given me lots of aid. My doctor makes me feel unafraid. Why do I love my dear old Dr. Merle? Well, can you believe that I used to be a girl?
I am a doctor, yes, I'm very bad. Boy, it makes my patients really, really mad. The last guy that I had still hasn't healed. I should have been gentler when I fluffed his Garfield.
I went to see my doctor in his big white cape. He told me that I really need to get in shape. Boy, I really hate him, his words I despise, but I think that today I better start to exercise.
Don't make fun of the police, I say stop, because one of my best friends is a cop. Because I like the way that they do their thing, I say, hey, it's a good thing my name isn't Rodney King.
When I was arrested, it wasn't good for me. They beat me and they stripped me and they searched my cavity. Why did this happen to such a guy, you say? Well, tell you the truth, it was 'cause I was arrested in L.A.
Quite unbalanced, my mind is not that steady. I once pummeled a guy with an ever ready. They took me down to jail and they arrested me, and they charged me with assault with a battery.
I got
got sent to prison, I didn't know what to do. I felt so bad because I was so new. Didn't know the ways there, I felt like such a dope. But now I never bend down to pick up any soap.
Girl, but then she went and left me cause I made her nose hair curl. She said she had to leave, she cried and fell to bits. She said it's not your face, it's just your pits. They are the pits.
Woo! Well, my wife left me, she ran out the door. She took all the furniture, she cleared me to the floor. When I asked her why, she said I smelled like no other. She said I smelled as bad as an episode of Big Brother.
There is a question that's been asked through the ages. Nobody has the answer, controversy rages. But I know the answer is exactly what you think. Dinosaurs had B.O., now they're all extinct.
Everybody want to go have a, go to the bathroom for a while. Come back in. I'm phased out.
Okay. I got one. How are we doing?
Come over here. Stand behind me and sing it.
Oh, I went on a date last night. It really didn't end well. She said she wouldn't kiss me because I had a weird smell. I said, come on, baby, why don't you have a heart? Sure, I might have B.O., but at least I didn't fart.
Street boys, I think they really stink. It isn't anything personal, they're just not in sync. This might be kind of weird, it could be a shock, but I still got a poster of the New Kids on the Block.
Well, I hate radio today. They don't have anything good to play. All they play is junk, they are in a rut. I wish they'd take the Backstreet Boys and shove them up their butt.
I hate the Backstreet Boys, they bug me like no one else can. So I came up with a really cunning plan. I kidnapped them and then I showed them, oh, how to hurt. I made them all wear a copy of my shirt.
A lot of people think that the best ones in the land, but the Backstreet Boys aren't my kind of band. Many people think that they are heaven sent, but you're not a band unless you play an instrument.
I moved to Hollywood to see if I could act. About 5 years ago, to this day to be exact, I thought being a director, it would be groovy. My first directing job was in a homemade Drew Porter movie.
My first directing job, it was really great. Fans lined up to see it, they can really wait. It was really the bomb. It was a porno movie starring Wayne's mom.
I'm a big director, I keep egos in check. Stars rant and rave at me, but I think, what the heck? Nothing really scares me, I know no fear. Nothing scares me since Ryan licked my ear.
Our director, he really is the boss. For yelling and screaming, he's never at a loss. He's the meanest guy that you will ever see. He should sprout a mustache and move to Germany.
Well, I love hockey, the game can't be beat. Where else can you do a job where you're missing teeth? I get plenty of dates, see, I'm never lonely. I take off my hockey costume and ride naked on the Zamboni.
Well, I met a girl last night at the hockey game. One look at her, I knew things would never be the same. We went back to my place, and I was in luck. She wanted to go to bed with me, and I said, hey, what the puck?
My battery pack.
I'm a hockey goalie, and boy, do I feel dumb. I forgot my shorts, and there is my bum. All the laughing, oh, when will it cease? I guess I look funny with a puck stuck in my crease. A puck stuck in my crease.
There I go, I'm in my car cruising. Problem is I've been out earlier boozing. I shouldn't have done the bad things that I did. The only upside is I was arrested by Ingrid.
The subject of my last arrest, well, I don't want to delve. They put me on the ground and showed me their Adam 12. Then they Starsky and Hutched me and threw me on the floor. And that's how I ended up in Hawaii with five hoes.
I've been arrested over 20 times. I've been arrested for many different crimes. People think it's horrible, but I think, what the hell? It's not that unusual. I play in the NFL.
I try to rob every store that I see. But one time I got caught by 40 cops. How could that be? I walked right in and I opened up the door. That's what I get for robbing a donut store.
To join the LAPD, LA's best. But I can't see, so I failed the vision test. I went one night to the church and prayed under the steeple. I wanted to be a cop so bad that I joined the village people.
Next year I'm gonna marry me a lady cop. Cause with her the sex is something I can't top. What's so sexy about her? Is that what you said? Well, I love it when she reads me my rights and tucks me to the bed.
I was once the best cop in all the land. People, as they saw me, go, boy, is he grand. I was so respected, believe me, I'm not lying, till I got fired for making an H with Ryan.
I got busted once, and boy, did that hurt. He wasn't very big, he was a little squirt. He tried to frisk me, threw me up against the wall. He had to get a ladder, cause I'm over 6 feet tall.
Magician all my life. I go around the house going, hey, surprise, doing those things to my wife. I want to go to Vegas. Her, I do annoy. If I was one half of an act, it'd be Siegfried and Leroy.
Hoedowns, my magicians are really hard to do. Hard to think of one verse, let alone even two. Let me tell you something that'll give you a little laugh. If you take a rhyme again, I'm gonna saw your ass in half.
There goes mine. Thank you, girl.
I am a great magician. I have this special hex. I can take a man and make him change his sex. It really is quite simple, the best trick in the world. I just tickle Wayne's bum and he screams like a girl.
Colin wants to be a magician, and I think he should. The only problem is he's not very good. He really sucks, he's the worst in the land. His best trick is pouring hot coffee on his hand. Ryan, he was really tired of the dating scene. He wanted to get a spouse who was never mean. He wanted a girl with brains and a girl that was kind of finer. So he mail ordered a chick all the way from China. What? The mail order bride.
When Ryan first met his wife, she fell in love with his nose. She couldn't wait to rip off all of his clothes. But then she found out something made her die. What they say about guys with big nose and big feet, it's a lie.
Oh, Ryan Stiles, I'd love to be his wife. He's the best lover that I've ever had in my life. After we've made love, boy, I'm really high stepping. Mel Gibson isn't the only one with a lethal weapon.
Getting married is what I always wanted to do. The happiest day was when my wife said, I love you. We're the happiest couple to anyone who's seen us. And it beats the hell out of us sitting around and pulling my own. Being Superman, it is really fun. Because you'd have powers and I'd use everyone. I would do it and fight for right. And then I would party, cause it's crypto night.
Superman is hunky and he looks good in his tights. He keeps ladies thinking of him at nights. But there's one thing that causes ladies pain. When he makes love to them, he's faster than a train.
Oh, Colin does remember all the time he spent wishing he was Superman or at least Clark Kent. He waited all his life, he waited for that day. But just like Superman, his hair was up, up, and away! Just like Superman, I've got special powers. I have fun with them, I could use them for hours. With my X-ray vision, I can do no wrong. Right now I'm looking at Drew Carey's thong. I met my girl at the zoo, and that's no junk. I'm dating an elephant that she has a trunk. And I love her, I give her my allegiance. Why, she doesn't want money, she just works for peanuts.
Well, we went to the
my girlfriend and I just to see some rhinoceri. But there weren't any around, so we went out to the lake and I went underwater and I showed her my snake.
I went to the zoo with my lovely girl. We had lots of fun there, we gave our love a whirl. Boy, we had such a really good time. This last time would be funny, but Drew took my rhyme.
A zoo is a place I don't wanna be. All of the animals really frighten me. Here comes a hippo. Oh no, it's kinda scary. Oh, it's not a hippo, it's just Drew Carey. It's just Drew Carey.
Well, I know that we're in matrimony, but I cheated on you, so I feel just like a phony. Now, girl, you see, from the day that we did marry, I was asleep with you, but I was making love to Drew Carey.
Let me tell you, ever since I was 13, you've given me the best loving that I've ever seen. Let me tell you something that I know you can't stand. I've been cheating on you with my other hand.
I've cheated on you, I've had women by the score. At last count, it was over 84. I don't care that you're mad or your pride is bent, 'cause I've just been pardoned by the ex-president.
I cheated on my wife with her sister and her mother. I also slept with her cousin and her brother. Boy, when she heard, boy, did it sting her. The good news is next week we're on Jerry Springer.
I love being a rock star. Pop songs make me sick. I fly around the world and I get a lot of chicks. This tour I've been a rock star that I thump because I sing my songs.
Yeah, I love being a rock star. I make them pay me in pearls. I make lots of money and get lots of teenage girls. And when I'm singing, I really got the power. Yeah, I'm a rock star when I'm naked in the shower.
I was a rock star, my image would be good. I would look so virile, like any rock star should. I put a cucumber in my pants so it looks like I don't lack. Of course it'd look much better if it wasn't in the back.
I wanna be a rock star, that's what I wanna do. I bet every one of you would like to be one too. I'd like to sing rock and roll, that's my kind of sound. You'd never hear me singing a stinking hoedown.
Mover right here in Hollywood. I pull up my truck and you know it's all good. I had to move Drew Carey and it was real queer. He didn't have no belongings, just a million cans of beer.
Last September I had a stressful day. I had to pack my stuff and move away. But one thing wrong, little man, I couldn't fit my fat ass in the van.
I had
to help a friend move, he worked in the coal mines. Because of doctor's orders, he had to move to warmer climes. It really turned out badly, I know I shouldn't whine, but I was arrested for transporting a miner over the state line.
Maybe this is the hoedown, I'll do real good this time. Hey, this is easy, I'm really starting to rhyme. It's going great, boy, I hope I have some luck. Cause last time I messed up, said a word that rhymes with duck.
Hey, I got a girlfriend, you know her name is Ruth. The reason that I love her is she always tells the truth. We have not made love not once since our inception. But now she's pregnant, she tells me it's immaculate conception.
I had this girlie, yes she was the best. Because she caused me, yes, a lot of stress. She drove me crazy and drove me insane. She showed me a little strip and said, here's a little Wayne.
I took a pregnancy test, it really was a topper. Because it took place upon a helicopter. My girlfriend, she went the full term. And all because the whirly bird got the sperm.
My girlfriend is pregnant, I just heard from her. Thinking about it, it just makes me go grrr. Someone makes me nervous, someone bring me towels. Cause when I just went grrr, I emptied all my bowels. I love to work out because I get a date. So I don't hesitate to go and grab a weight. People, here's a fact that I bet you didn't know. I got my butt this tight because I do Tybo.
Well, people always ask me, how do you stay in shape?
How?
How do you get that body? Is it lifting weights? Well, let me tell you something, my secret I hold dear. I got this body by lifting cans of beer. Hey! I don't like to work out, cause I'm very meek. I really can't do anything strenuous, cause I'm very weak. When I do actually work out, people filled with smiles. I can't lift anything heavy, so I bench press Ryan Stiles.
I really don't have to sing this song anymore. It could turn out to be a real big bore. I know I'll win this game, I'm not better than the rest. But I'm sleeping with Denny and she's behind the desk.
Be a duck, because in the community he is a rock. Then a Hippocratic oath, you've got to take it. The worst part of a doctor's job is seeing these three naked.
I love going to my doctor, it gives me such a thrill. I go to my doctor even when I am not ill. Now you may think that I'm in a rut, but I am not. See, his nurse got a nice butt. That's why I go to the doctor, because his nurse got in. I am a doctor, famous as can be. Throughout the world, I'm renowned for my surgery. They're going to make a movie about me in the future. It really is incredible. It's called Back to the Suture.
and it really is kind of scary. Things are happening to me involuntary. I know something really is amiss. Every time I go out, I can't stop doing this.
Story. Just the other day, I was stopped by a cop for speeding around the way. All those speed limits, you know that I did break it, but I wasn't speeding in a car, I was streaking butt naked.
I drive fast, I do it all the time. Usually 105, sometimes 109. Burning rubber, flipping off the CHP, cause they don't give no ticket to a rich celebrity.
I did 120 while riding my bike. I was stopped by a great big cop, his name was Mike. I got up to that speed by unusual means. I knew I shouldn't have that extra helping of beans.
One day as a joke, I gave a cop the finger. I took off real fast, I didn't want to linger. I headed on the freeway, I didn't get too far. Stupid me, I was walking, I wasn't in a car.
So let's do the...
I'm having an affair, stepping out on my spouse. Late night calls and running from my house. This affair has got me, its hold on me is mighty. No, it isn't with a woman, my affair is with Righty.
Well, I'm single, so you may ask, how can I cheat? Well, I have a method, and that method can't be beat. What I've discovered is an affair to remember. I'm thinking about Miss June while I'm looking at Miss November.
I feel so horrible, I cheated on my wife. I haven't felt this bad in my entire life. The affair happened at the restaurant where I waited. The best part was the affair was catered.
My wife caught me with a prostitute. She came into the room and she began to shoot. And then she went and yelled all around the town. I know there's more prostitutes, I guess that's one hoedown. I guess that's one hoedown.
I'm gonna tell you folks a little tale about how I won the battle of the scale. See, my weight would hurt me, my heart, it would break it. How I lost weight, I picture Drew standing naked.
Well, people always ask me, hey Drew, did you lose weight? And I tell them, thanks, I feel great. I find a diet plan that's like no other. I burn all my calories, Wayne's.
I don't think it's funny that I'm overweight. People make fun of me, boy, that isn't great. The things that they said, boy, it's made me cry. Some kid snuck up and wrote Goodyear on my side.
Singing about weight, I don't know where to begin. As you've noticed, I really am quite thin. I watch my weight, I don't want to end up dead. There's very few calories in licking Colin's head.
Blind date and had many fears. I hadn't had a date in about 10 years. Veronica was a really great gal, yes, you understand. But at the end of the night, I found out Veronica was a man.
Well, I thought a blind date would really be a treat. So I went out with my blind date and got a bite to eat. Well, I can tell you it was a terrific date. The guy was just but the seeing eye dog was great.
I had a blind date. It really was the pits. Nothing worked all night. I kept getting hit. She really was abusive. Man, oh man, oh man. But what else can you expect when your blind date is Roseanne?
I had a blind date, she was better than the rest. When it comes to women, I would have to say she's best. Blue eyes, long legs, and really good blonde hair. Every time I go to date, I fill her full of air.
Professor, I've got a PhD. I am so smart, no one is smarter than me. I am a professor, I've been one all night. In fact, I am a professor, I hope Chip guessed it right.
Well, when I get in the ring, it is such a treat. I knock my opponents right off their feet. Why do I wrestle with all my might? It's because I look good in wrestling tights.
It's Professor. It's Professor.
Oh, no. I am a dentist. My duty I won't shirk. My assistant wants to do all of my work. No, you can't, I said to her. Her name is Ruth. Why not? She said, I said, you can't handle the tooth!
My wife is so cute, she's from North Carolina. We decided to get married off in China. 1 billion people came and it was really nice. And after the ceremony, they threw pork fried rice.
I am getting married, I'll get drunk and go on a bender. All I really want is a really nice blender. When we get married on our honeymoon, we'll have one room. He and I are both the groom.
When I think of my wedding day, it really sticks out in my mind. Gee, I love that woman. She was one great find. When I think of that night, boy, the memories do flow. On our honeymoon, we stayed up all night and watched the Drew Carey Show.
I get so excited when I go to a wedding. I get really bad, you have to change my bedding. I must have kissed the bride for 3 hours at least. That was the wrong thing because I am the priest.
I don't like to study, but I have no fear. I'd rather sit in my dorm room and drink lots of beer. If I fail my tests, I have a special scheme. It doesn't matter what my grades, I'm on the football team.
Professor,
first one from my family. I was such a smarty. When I got to college, all I did was yell and party. Graduation should have been a time I celebrated, but I missed my midterms because I was inebriated.
In the middle of midterms from my study room, I do not stir. Everything's coming at me. There's too much pressure. I can't take it. I can't take it.
We are having midterms this afternoon in class. Oh boy, this time I really hope I pass. There's nothing that I'd like to do more than walk out that door. But I better hurry, cause I'm turning 64.
Thank goodness for my mom that I was made. It was 27 years ago that my dad got. That's right, you see, upon closer inspection, I'm standing here cause he didn't use protection.
When I finally meet a guy who appreciates my worth, we'll get married and 9 months later, I just might give birth. Well, birth is what can end up happening when you have lots of kisses and hugs. But I don't care about this natural stuff, give me lots of drugs.
Guess what my wife gave birth the other day? I really supported her. I was there all the way. Before the time went by, before the time sure passes, then I cut the cord. I really should have worn my glasses.
The day I was born, my daddy really did care. He wore a surgical mask, and yes, he was right there. People said he looks just like you. I guess it was a curse, cause I happened to come out ass first.
I hate him if you please. He's really loud at chopping logs and he's a sawing Z's. I don't know why he makes so much noise in his bed, but last night I had too much and cut off his head.
My wife says my snoring, it is way too loud. My wife, my snoring and me, that's a real big crowd. My wife, she hates it when I'm snoring and I'm laying prone, because my snoring covers up my wife's moans.
I'm a loud snorer. I do it all the time. The way my wife goes on about it, you'd think it was a crime. It really is so horrible. I wish I could stop real close. The worst thing of all, though, I don't snore through my nose.
I snore real loudly each and every night. Sometimes my wife and I get into a huge fight. I guess it's kind of bad, I don't show a lot of class. I snore so hard I suck the sheets right out my.
I'm a human vending machine, it's really awfully dandy. Just give me your money, cause my belly's full of candy. Look right through the display in the window, here's the glass. Give me your quarter, I'll shoot some candy.
I love vending machines, that is why I sing. In this newfangled age, you can get almost anything. You can get a Bible if you're a theologian. And if you're really horny, you can even get a Trojan.
There's a song about a vending machine. I hope it makes much sense. Just listen very carefully, because it's totally in French. La chocolate, the chips, et oui, et pour de don de chine. Et mais la coin, we boule le fou, ou la caisse gros.
Singing a song about a vending machine. Don't you know that it's really not my scene? Trying to think of something clever with a little twist. If we do another hoedown, I'll slit my wrist.
If other hobbies leave you in the lurch, you can always break out your chisel and carve yourself a perch. That's right, you can carve a marble or a granite. Just go ahead and have at it.
You may spend a couple hours cleaning up the sediment from that age-old fallen pediment. But once you have done it, you will notice with ease that it's one of them Grecian frieze.
Well, you know, carving is lots of fun. It's cheaper to buy the rocks by the ton. I like it when I'm carving when I'm alone, but I find it's a lot easier when I am stone.
Everybody chisel your marble, chisel with ease. Chisel your marble, please. Chisel your marble, chisel it right down. When you're sculpting, you won't wear a frown. Chisel your marble, that's all I can say. Hit the stone at it in every day. You can make just anything you want. Chisel your marble, chisel it right down.
Yes, very good. Hey.
Out on the prairie, it's real dry. We don't know why. We wait for it to rain and so we can take a dive. We put on our masks and put on our tanks and dive right into the dirt. And then when we hit our heads on a rock, damn, it really hurts. Woo! I like to put on real tight clothes and then go underwater. But every time I get there, I wonder if I oughta. 'Cause then I see lots of things. They're swimming, swimming fish. And they make me talk breakfast. I love all the fishies, all the sharkies too. When I see one come towards me, I swim like you. I love all the friends down there, hey, don't you know? There's a friend of mine, the very popular Jacques Cousteau.
Yeah. Okay, that's some fruity George Brown sheet cowboy dancing. I'm a scuba diver boy. I dive for pearls and I'll pick them up like toys. And when I'm deep and I really got no cares, until I turn real blue 'cause I ain't got no air.
He's got no air. He's got no air.
He's got no air.
To college, I wasn't very smart. I'd throw my hands up, giving up at the very start. Every test I'd take, you know, a test that would I fail. But it doesn't matter, 'cause I am Dan Quayle. I had to take an exam. I studied very hard. I thought up very, very hard and put things on a card. I studied, studied, tried all my best. And then I went and realized it was a urine test.
Oh, I love exams. They are so much fun.
I love to take the paper and sit down on my bum. Oh, I am very smart. Oh, it might sound kind of silly, but I pass every test because I write notes right there in my willy.
I hate examinations, it fills me with such fear. I get the collie wobbles and lots of diarrhea. So if you are a student, don't care about the pain. Get through your exams by taking lots of cocaine. Lots of cocaine.
Haircuts, it really is a drag, cause I think that my barber is a mighty hag. Every time I sit in the chair, I just say damn my luck, cause he always cuts my ear and then I yell out darn.
To get a haircut, I need to save up a few bob. To get a nice, neat one so I can get that new job. But when I went in, I came out a little bit queerer. I hadn't been to the hairdresser, I'd been to the sheep shearer.
Oh, I'm not sure of my barber. I think he's kind of strange. The way he likes to play with my hair, he always rearranged. I'm not sure about him. I don't think he's my kind of guy. But I can't complain when he likes to blow me dry.
England, I met me a man. He was shiny and bald, his name was Clive Anderson. There was some confusion. I said, where's the freeway? He said, no, you silly twat, it's called a motorway.
I use the motorway each and every day. It really turns a lot like work, it really is not play. I got hit badly, and why do you suppose? I got rear-ended by a guy picking his nose.
Driving home from work can be lots of fun. Driving down the highway when your work is done. I love to watch the bugs as they splat against my glass. The last thing that grows through their mind is their big fat ass.
I like the sound of motorways when things go splat. I look out my car window and I've run over a cat. The thing I really hate, the worst thing in my life, is the stupid bastard who designed the M25.
I was riding my donkey up a stony pass. I fell off onto the grass. I saw a man and he helped me back on. That's why I sing this song.
I like to ride my donkey. I ride him all day long. He is very, 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 very strong.
I am a donkey. I love to haul the goods. I think that's the way every donkey should. As I am hauling, never without fail, someone comes and pokes a pin right in my tail.
I love my fluffy donkey, I like to call him Clive. I dress him up in panties, he's the best animal alive. I like to dress him up in lots of frilly clothes. Then the two of us begin to star in certain videos.
Well, went to my doctor's and he said to me, what you need is a vasectomy. Gotta cut your balls off and put them in a jar. And then he took his hat off and went, ha 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 ha.
I fight fires in Germany. They really are the worst. I now will do German in my next verse. Ich liebe dich, grüß dich, das Mädchen ist exploding. Look at that, jumping, jumping, all the trampolinen.
Some people think it's a really lousy job, but I love the fact working around somebody's knob. Everybody thinks that it's a job that really stinks, but I save up all the spare parts and I make out cufflinks.
The doctor went to work that day, he started right down there. He snipped around my tezzies and around my pubic hair. And for that job I'm very grateful, yes I do give thanks. Cause now every time I make love I'm always shooting blanks.
Always shooting blanks.
The favorite thing in my life is such a crazy dream. I'd like to be a movie star up there on the screen, but I'll never be a movie star, no, 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 cause I'm too busy snugging on the backbone.
I love film, I could watch them all night. I like watching them when I'm in flight. The ones on the aeroplanes, well, the screen is too small, but that's all right, don't bother me, I've only got one ball.
I am the person that people want to kill. Don't really mind, to me it's kind of a thrill. I'm used to it now, to me it's nothing new, cause I'm the guy that comes in and sits in front of you.
I saw her film the other day, it wasn't very good. It starred something that looked like a plank of wood. I looked a little closer, I must have been going insane. It wasn't a plank of wood at all, it was Michael Caine.
It was Michael Caine.
Well, I love Christmas, I wish it was every day. I love Christmas, do you hear what I say? Sometimes I go up and sometimes I go down. Did you know there was a man called Coco the Clown?
I love my Christmas, I love it every year. Cause I shove food in my mouth, I grin ear to ear. My cholesterol is high and...
I really love Christmas, it's better than the rest. When it comes to holidays, you know it is the best. I like to celebrate, I guess I know how it goes. That's why I prefer to sleep with a reindeer with a red nose.
I like Father Christmas, you know he's hell of a man. I try to see him once a year as often as I can. When he comes, I do all the locks. And he comes down the chimney and he fills up my socks.
He fills up my socks.
And we're ending up with Jenny.
I'm a randy bugger, I really get around. I like to have a shag with everyone in town. I have lots of fun, I'm as happy as can be. And that's cause my name is Tony Slattery. I love making love, I do it every day. My girlfriend's a contortionist, we do it every way. It's really quite remarkable the ways that she can bend. She also is a psychic, she foresaw her own end.
<Woo! laughs>
Living in the country, there's really not much to do. I love to grab anything and have a real good screw. I guess it's really bad, I guess it's kind of sad, but my girlfriend looks at me and says, hey, you're not bad.
I'm a little kinky, my panties are made of fur. I like to stay in evenings, just me and my cucumber. And then I pull my pants down and start to paint my tush, and dress up in leather and squat on Barbara Bush.
Squat on Barbara Bush.
Underwater, I do a coral jig. I live there with my friend, a tiny inflatable pig. Wearing a rubber suit, that is my fervent wish. I scuba dive all day long so I can have sex with fish. Woo!
Take it, boy.
3 feet under, I'm in the water here. I've got my mask on and feeling good, oh dear. I'm nuzzling up to fishes, I'm on the deep blue sea. I can't have enough fun like Jacques Cousteau, you see. Ha ha!
I'm not very good at swimming, I hope that I don't drown. And if I do, I hope that sooner or later my body's found. I think I'm going there now, my vision's getting soft. Where the hell when you need 'em is David Hasselhoff.
I like my scuba diving kit, my pleasure never ends. As long as I don't surface quickly, then I get the bends. I get all my friends and my uncles and aunties, and the most important equipment is my waterproof panties.
Waterproof panties!
I like trick or treating, I go from door to door. I ask for candy, ask for sweets, and then I ask for more. Sometimes they give me lots of rocks and bugs, but I do not care, cause I trick or treat on drugs.
Oh, I'm so glad that Halloween is finally here, cause Halloween's my favorite time of the entire year. I dress up and give all the kids an awful fright. I really don't know why I'm not wearing a mask tonight. Last Halloween there was terrible blizzard. It was caused by a nasty old wizard. He looked out his window and caused a fearful spell. And when I woke up in the morning, I did smell.
Such a special night. It's a chance you get to run around and scare and fright. When people open the door, oh boy, do they run. That's because every year I dress as Clive Anderson.
I used to like the booze, I used to like the chicken, but now I get my kicks going out toad licking. I go out to the desert and find myself a frog and lick it psychedelic back till I'm high as a dog.
Out on the plains there ain't no liquor store. There's just some big cactus and not very much more. But the agave, I tell you, gives the juice. You put it in, let it ferment, it really cuts you loose.
And then I cut it off.
Three drinking lots of liquor can go right to your head. Well, one day I drank so much that I woke and I was dead. Oh, drinking, it really takes some nerve, but at least I'm dead. Hey, I am well preserved.
When my father passed away, we had to read the will. I didn't turn up, cause I was feeling ill. I got a letter in the post, it said I had 3 million quid. So I went out and bought a horse, and this is what I did.
The other day I went to my dad's funeral. He crossed himself with an elephant, it didn't go too well. The elephant was willing, my daddy, he said, ouch. It took me 27 days to scrape him off the couch.
My brother passed away last week, I guess that's kind of sad, because he's the best brother that I have ever had. But he will always be with me, because we made a pact. I'll put my hand right up him and start a ventriloquist act.
My mother died the other day, I hit her with a cosh. I hoped that in the will she would leave me lots of dosh. But when I read the will I found out that I was not rich. She just left me her knickers, what a stupid bitch.
Last night I waited all night long. I waited for my boyfriend, I sang a little song. Where in the hell are you, darling dear? But he didn't turn up, so I'm still waiting here.
Oh, I met a girl I really, really liked. I hoped that she'd come over, but she wouldn't. Can you believe it? I've been waiting. I've been waiting. No call. No phone call.
When it comes to girls, I seem to have some kind of hex. I can never get what I want, and that is sex. I just run around and scream and I rant. I guess I should just pay money like my friend Hugh Grant.
I waited in the restaurant, I waited just all night. I drank so much whiskey, I began to get quite tight. And then no one turned up in the end, and I thought, oh no. And then I kissed a Labrador, and then I...
When I was a young man, I went to my friend's house for tea. But he was growing up too fast, he was going through puberty. He had hairs on his top lip and underneath his arms. His mother came in and caught us kissing and joined in.
Ho, ho, I hate puberty. All my things are sticking out and I have got acne. Ho, oh, oh, and you're not about to grow. So if this is a hoedown, I'll just do the dough.
I like going gray, I really, really do. I really, 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 please don't misconstrue. To many it's a source of consternation, but I'm quite happy with my hair pigmentation.
Things are starting to happen to me way below my belt. It's the strangest thing that I have ever felt. I turn out the lights and I play with my crotch every night when I watch all the girls on Baywatch.
Should. I sometimes get a bit of dirt right between my teeth. Makes me feel just great to bite my nails just for nice.
I never, never, never bite my own.
There's one thing I really shouldn't do. It's my nails that I love to chew. Day after day, I can't stop. What a twist. I've chewed off all my fingers. Now I'm nibbling on my wrist.
I really like to chew my nails. I do it all night through. And then when I finish, I say to myself, phew. And then I go and get myself ice cream with raspberry ripple. And after that, I begin to suck and swallow my own nipples.
Life is very fickle from birth to the tomb. But I remember one day when I came out of the womb. I came out a spluttering and covered in green mush. The first thing that I heard was push, push, push.
My son was born the other day. It really was exciting, really, really in a big way. I looked at him there with his great big smile. I didn't know I had him upside down all the while.
All I really feel is a doctor's hands on my bum. He's pulling really hard and I'm afraid here I come. I want to stay where I am, don't want to leave that tube. Hey, but since I'm out here, give me some of that big old boob.
Big old boob.
I went up the Eiffel Tower just the other day. I threw off myself, my braces and they swayed. I went down and I went up and down and up again. I went up down so fast, I ended up in Big Ben.
The other day my girlfriend said, Greg, you want a thrill? She took me to a bridge at the bottom of a hill. She tied a cord to my back and I ran out of luck. Cause when she pushed me off it, I just yelled out, wow.
I love to bungee jump. I do it every day. It's such a nifty, 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 nifty way to play. I like to do it, and people say it's dangerous, but it depends. I find it really dangerous cause I don't tie the other end.
I like to jump off bridges, it's really lots of fun. But I'm in a lot of pain when the day is done. I don't have a cord, but you never hear me blubber. I can still go up and down, my penis is made of rubber.
Politicians, they really are a drag. Bumming common people, that just ain't my bag. But I am a waffler and a total prat. So next election I will vote Liberal Democrat.
No one likes our party, they think we're full of shit. Divided over Europe and most of us are split. We're going off on holiday, I do not really care. The feel-good factor's coming soon, its name is Tony Blair. Hey!
Politics is very strange, it confuses me a lot. There's Tories, Liberals, Whigs and others put me on the spot. They do things very strange.
wants to really be in charge. People who want power will do anything on a dare. As a matter of fact, that's why Clive ripped out all his hair.
I'm scared of spiders and animals too, so I really freak out when I'm at the zoo. But the things that scare me most of all, and occasionally now and then, are those great big tall long leggy things they call women.
Made love to a girl called Sheila. When we made love, she proved to be a bit of a squealer. But I was scared, but there isn't anything finer than to see her, cause she's from Asia Minor.
I'm afraid of women, especially at night. They always come towards me, they give me such a fright. They're leathery and small and their wings get in my hair. Oh, wait a minute, it's not women, it's vampire bats.
My girlfriend's kind of special, she's one of a kind. Down in Soho is where I did fine. When I put my mouth on her, she really starts to blubber. I guess that's what you get from a girl made of rubber.
I went to my grandmother's just the other week. She greeted the door and gave my nipple a tweak. She's always doing that to me when my back is turned. Last week she opened a coal shed and there was a milker.
I love my grandmother because she is very nice. I go and see her on Sundays and she gives me some advice. Like always use a biro and never shave your legs. And tomorrow she's teaching me how to suck eggs.
I discover that we are a bit more than friends. The teeth right off her gums.
Hi, ich bin ein German, my name is Helmut Kohl. And you know, kids, I really, really like to rock and roll. I like to go to America, it's where I get my kicks. Cause President Clinton knows all the easy chicks.
Welcome to World Leaders, my name is David Frost. I'm bringing you world leaders, no matter what the cost.
I'm a sort of world leader, I'm a pleasant kind of fella.
But I'm an even nicer bloke, my name's Nelson Mandela.
I'm a world leader, I hate democracy. Because you know I'm a dictator, you see. I'm gonna make people march to and fro and back. The best thing about being dictator is I look good in black.
Once I ruled Israel with an iron hand. I was the best leader in all of the land. Sure, I was rich, but no one lived in fear. I've got silver in my pocket and gold in my ear.
In my ear.
Oh, I'm a little baby. I live inside my mummy. In a couple months' time, I'll come out of her tummy. When I'm grown, I will run around on rugs. But so she doesn't cry, I hope she takes a lot of drugs.
I am. Hey, having a baby, it makes me want to bang, cause nothing's more painful than seeing that thing drop through your legs.
There's nothing more beautiful in this great big earth than watching a wife giving birth. Just seeing it filled me with ecstasy. The thing I liked best was, thank God it wasn't me.
Watching a baby come out can be really neat. I pull up a chair and I sit right down at her feet. They've called the police on me, so I'm heading out the door. Apparently because it's she's never seen me before.
I'm a Western boy, I lock my pants real tight. I like them long and lean and fitting just right. When I slip them on, they feel so nice and coolie. Especially when they've lynched me up and I'm pressed up against my ghoulie.
I think pasta is religious. In fact, I think it's holy. I cover myself in marinara and pads of ravioli. I sometimes clean al dente with using it like floss. And sometimes I stir it in my pants to make the special sauce.
I love wearing pants that are very, very tight. I wear them in the day and I wear them in the night. Sure, sometimes it just cuts off my circulation, but I don't...
When I go out clubbing, my pants are mighty tight. Sometimes it gets me in many, many fights. Everybody looks at me, they go, you son of a gun. But I'm not actually wearing any, they're just painted on.
They're just painted on.
Yeehaw! I've been having problems with me and my feller, so we went to see a marriage counselor. Her name was Helen, she was very nice. Now I live with her instead, and my life is full of spice.
It's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
Music and sex are very similar to me. I just can't make them. Whatever I do, or whatever I try to, I find the best way is to fake them. I've been to that Ann Summers shop. I've been in every branch. The only way I can really get it off is with Richard Branch.
I'm a great blue whale and I live undersea. I'm having problems with my wife and me. She always talks about old boyfriends. It really makes me sick. Well, how the hell can I compare to a guy named Moby Dick?
I live in the U.S., married a girl from the South. She's always screaming, got a really big old mouth. She comes out a swinging, a screaming, and a fussing. I guess that's what you get when you marry your sister's brother's cousin.
My sister's brother's cousin.
My brother got married, his name is Gromit, and when he walked down the aisle, I began to vomit. The vicar cleared it up and put it under the cake, and at the wedding reception, we all sat and ate cake flake.
Very near.
Is that it then?
That's it.
All right.
I believe in marriage, I think it is a treat. And on the day I married, I looked so very neat. But a couple years later, I began to cry. It made me totally sick because my name is Lady Di.
I hate hate weddings. They make me really sick. Just looking at them makes me go ick ick. I really just hate them. I hate them all the time. You know what I hate most of all? Greg just took my rhyme.
I make the wedding dresses in my special way. I make them for those pretty girls on their special day. But sometimes I get angry and I make such a fuss when I lift up the dress and find the bride's got a penis.
Oh, I'm a tiny Martian, I'm green and full of mirth. I have one mission only, to dominate the earth. I'll give you a new leader, and he won't take no jive. He's got no neck, his hair is bald, and his name is Clyde.
We got a problem, Houston. I don't have the right stuff. I'm going to space now to look for stuff that they make fluff out of. Dance break!
My wife and I are astronauts and we need information. We've been made to have some sex upon the old space station. We did it and wouldn't you know, we got into a bad fight. Hey, is it my fault that I'm faster than the speed of light?
Just me and another guy floating around space, just to break the boredom. Sometimes he wears lace. Houston knows about it, but they never make a fuss unless they catch me circling around his Uranus. Starting there.
I'm a cricket player. I stand upon the pitch. I wait for the ball to come, and then I give it a switch. When the game is over, I retire for a beer. And I know what you're thinking, and no, we're not.
I hate watching cricket. How do they do that play? It seems to run and run and run. It goes on for 50 days. It takes so long, it takes so long. It really is a crime. In the time it takes to play cricket, I can make love 455 times.
I'm going to the cricket match with a pretty girl. I really don't like the game, but hey, let's give it a whirl. I sit there and make fun, oh boy, I pick it, until she leans over and grabs my sticky wicket.
When I go to sleep, I have nightmares all the time. I have this weird dream, I'm covered in lime. And a giant licks me really, really hard. And by the time he's finished, I've turned to a lump of lard.
I have lots of nightmares and I try to be brave. I'm covered in Vaseline with my mom in a cave. Then in the morning, I wake up from a chance. And in there in my bed is Colin in my pants.
I go to sleep, I go to sleep each night. And when I have a horrible dream, it gives me quite a fright. I've had a carnival and that big cotton candy I've won. I eat it, and when I wake up, I find my pillow's gone.
When I go to sleep at night, you know my biggest fear, that walking around my room is some sort of creature.
Start over.
When I go to sleep, I'm so afraid of the dark. Then one night I turned on the lights just for a lark. Ah, right before me is a really ugly creature.
then I realized that I'm looking in the mirror.
When I was a schoolboy, my teacher said to me, I'm gonna teach you golf. This is called a tee. You put the ball on it and swing very hard, but make sure you use a club and not a piece of lard.
You stunned me. Next to Colin Mockery, he really is a chum. Before we shoot the program, he lets me pat his bum. But when we go out golfing, it really makes me sick, cause he always asks me to grab onto his stick. What am I, a genius?
I love playing golf, I play it all the time. Though the way I play it, some think it is a crime. My golfing instructor told me it was lots of fun. When he stepped in front of me, whoops, hole in one.
When I go golfing, we always bet a buck. And my friend kisses me, he kisses for good luck. I'm not saying I'm aroused, cause he is just a friend. But when he smooches me, it makes my putter stand on end.
Putter stand on end.
I was in the courtroom just the other day, and the jury, I began to sway. I was doing my final speech, it was going really well, when the judge fell asleep. Bloody hell!
I'm a lawyer and I needed to hire an assistant. I saw a girl outside and she was awfully persistent. She came in and told me all her legal beliefs. Later on I fell asleep and she went through my briefs.
Sue for everything, it really makes no sense. I just got a suit against me because of impotence. I really thought it was awful, I felt like such a bad sport, but luckily they couldn't make it stand up in court.
Big mistake and I stole the car. Cops pulled me over before I got too far. I know I'll get convicted and go to the pen, cause I'm being represented by Clive Anderson.
It makes me so excited, and if I were to win it, I'm sure I'd be delighted. But every time I go to the shop, it is just a drag. I see the shopkeeper and I have to give him a shag. So I get excited.
I just won the lottery, my lucky number 6. Having won the lottery, I'm gonna pick up loads of chicks. I'm gonna take them out and take them for dining, and then I'll have fun with them all. I can't wait to see the smile on their face when I see my bonus ball.
If I win the lottery, I'd be one happy clown, cause then I would hire someone to do this hoedown. So if what I say isn't funny and you're vexed, don't worry, cause Ryan's coming up with funny, he's next.
I hope to win the lottery with a lot of luck. Boy, when I go crazy, I'd probably even I wouldn't change it all, I'd keep my same old life. Sure, I'd go to the whorehouse and maybe kick out my wife.
Kick out my wife.
Shocked.
I call it. I really, really do. I really, 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 really do. And when I sing like Colin, it makes me have great joy because I... No!
Well, there is a man they call the king of whose line. His soul is on fire and his mind is very fine. He does a hoedown and he very rarely sucks, 'cause he is one talented, funkily challenged Canuck.
Everybody's having fun, they're singing all about me. Let's all laugh along with them, ha 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 hee hee. It really is amusing, can't you all see? Look at them, of me they're making a mockery.
You've got to love Colin, love him to the end. I have to admit that he is my best friend. I would not lie to you, this is no jive. Anyway, you look at it, he's still got more hair than Clyde.
In England, I'll have a cup of tea. I'll drink a cafe latte when I'm in Italy. But when I'm in America, I have lots of luck. I order coffee from fast food place, but it's hot as...
cups as the day passes, but I don't feel real up unless I take 12 cups and shove them up my ass.
I drink a little coffee, I really, really do. I really don't know what to do. I really do. I think the caffeine's not affecting me. I really don't know what to do, but you know, I drink it. I really like it. I deserve that.
Lattes and cappuccinos, I really can't see. I like black coffee and everyone laughs at me. When I order, they think I have some class. Why don't they take that espresso machine and shove it up their ass?
I hunt for suspects everywhere, both near and so far. I hunt for secretaries and the president's wife. The reason that I'll do all this is I have no life.
Well, there's plenty of reasons to be commander-in-chief. To help the people and give social relief. To do something that might help the world. Or, of course, you could just do it to get the girls.
What the hell's going on? The country's gone to pot. The president's having lots of sex while I am not. I think it's really horrible. It's really quite a sin. Why don't we hire a celibate like Wilt Chamberlain?
I think we have the best president that I've ever seen. The way his sexy voice sounds, I think he's really keen. A lot of people think he's a crook, they think something's amiss. Of course, what do I know? I'm just a stewardess. I'm just a stewardess.
I am an omnivore, I eat anything. I eat it all because I am the king. 'Cause when it comes to eating down, beggars can't be choosers. Because if I ate too much, I'd be on The Biggest Loser.
I love eating bacon. I like eating beans. I love all high fiber, the most you've ever seen. I eat 50 pounds a day. I don't get fat, don't fear, because I've had diarrhea for 15 years.
My wife's a vegetarian and she won't eat no meat. And though she won't eat it, I still think she's so sweet. When we go to dinner and come home and go to bed, she will never eat me, so I eat myself instead.
Eating roadkill, 'cause I'm a country boy. I see a critter on the road, it brings me so much joy. Hell, I am sure glad that I live by a dam. Lately, I've been eating all the beaver that I can.
Top we sit. In fact, I feel just like an unopened box of Ritz. I hate making jokes like this, even though I'm blacker. But if we're talking about this, I'm the cheese and they're the crackers.
I love eating cheese. I love it all day long. If you eat your cheese, you can never go wrong. I get Ryan to act with me. Yes, it does please. 'Cause I always like to have a little ham with my cheese.
Where does cheese come from a cow? Ooh, moo. I like cheese and Colin does too. When he eats too much, he gets a little sick. And with that last remark, Colin, you can Gouda, Swiss, and Monterey, and some Camembert. These are all some lovely cheeses with a lot of flair. I can't believe Ryan asked for that nasty job, but I guess it would taste better if he put cheese on his knob.
Turning 18 and I've even got a cake. I am so happy that I just might pop. The best time about turning 18 is finally my balls dropped.
I just turned 18, I'm at the prime of life. I feel so good, I do not have so strife. Everything's so wonderful, nothing in life does stink. Best of all, I'm Canadian, at 18 I can drink.
Oh, I just turned 18 and I think it's really great. I'm gonna go out somewhere and yes, I'll celebrate. I'll get all dressed up and yes, oh boy, I'm a looker. I think I'll go straight to Vegas and get myself a hooker.
The happiest guy that you've ever seen. Here's the reason why. I am 18. Now when I say 18, please don't get me wrong. I don't mean my age, I mean I'm 18 inches long.
18 inches long. Now y'all that know me, about sports. With baseball playing guys, normally I don't consort. But I met this pretty girl, man, real for real. She let me get down and go to her Wrigley Field.
My wife likes baseball, she's a baseball loving girl. That's good for me, I'm the richest man in the world. I bought her a playing field, the best that money could spend. 'Cause everyone knows a diamond is a girl's best friend.
I'm a baseball catcher, and that takes a lot of guts.
squatting there looking at other players' butts. I have to admit, I don't know where they've been. Just last week I took two balls to the chin.
Baseball is the pastime of the grand old USA. We like to go out to the park and watch those guys all play. And once I met a baseball gal, I thought she was top-notch. But just like all the players, she won't stop scratching crotch. Won't stop scratching crotch.
It's time for the Hoedown!
I graduated high school today and...
I had an interview. Oh, shit.
When I was a young boy, I thought I'd never change. And then as I got older, I started feeling strange. One day I was standing, and then I saw a girl. And when I saw her booty, it
totally rocked my world.
My wife gave birth yesterday. Well, guess what? My wife just gave birth the other day. And I really supported her all the way. Time went for hours. Oh, hours were passing. Oh, God.
I love public restrooms. I love the way they smell. I walk in and take a breath and I just...
I had a blind date. It really was quite bad. It was my first one, for I'm Captain Ahab. You have this date, there were many highs and lows. She really hated it when I shouted, there she blows.
I don't file my taxes every single year. I guess it's the IRS I really, really fear. I guess that's bad of me, doesn't show a lot of class. But every time I do, they seem to fuck me up the ass.
Well, I miss the 60s, I miss them quite a lot. I'd sit around listening to music, it was really hot. Well, I do a lot of yard work, that's what's come to pass. Cause it's a cheap way to get my hands on grass.
I went to the machine to take out some money, and then I noticed there was something funny. As I came closer, my heart, boy, it sank. It was an ATM machine for a sperm bank.
I have had a transplant. It did not... Oh, shit.
I remember the day I lost my virginity. I took my woman and we drove to the city. Let me tell you, brother, she felt like no other. Boy, was I embarrassed when I found out it was my mother.
I like to grab my penis, I pull it all the time.
I went to an awful restaurant, they had to use these towels. And all the food was awful, tastes like something from your bowels. I had to leave so right away, cause it didn't really matter. What was I thinking, ordering the poo-poo platter?
A mosquito came up and he bit me. He took all my blood, can't you see how, see? I have a lot of blood loss.
Say you will, I'll stay in there all day, no matter what it takes. And when I leave, I always eat those tasty urinal cakes.
I'm an advertiser and I'm a groovy guy. I sit at home just thinking of stuff that you can buy. Lots of stuff that you don't need that will make fuck me.
The Hoedowns, I'm doing another one. After the first one, I thought that I was done. Feel like such a fool, and I feel like such a twit. This is what I have to do to please the fucking Brit.
Singing a song about a vending machine.
Don't you know that it's really not my scene? Trying to think of something clever with a little twist. If we do another hoedown, I'll slit my fucking wrist. Don't say it, man. Don't say another hoedown. Don't you even say another hoedown. Don't you go there, sister.